Hello and welcome to all the viewers. In this video, we will going to discuss about fatigue analysis of a bracket using ANSYS Mechanical. So this slide represents the learnings in this video. Very first, we will discuss about actual problem statement of our present video. Then we will discuss about what is fatigue, fatigue life estimation method, fatigue loading types. And then we will move towards our actual learning part, that is ANSYS learning. So here we discuss how to perform static as well as fatigue analysis. So at the last, we need to extract the fatigue analysis output, such as fatigue life, fatigue damage, safety factor, bioaxiality indication, then fatigue sensitivity. So this slide represents the problem statement of our present video. So here we need to perform the fatigue analysis for a constant loading, proportional loading and stress life approach for a bracket shown below. So if you see that the schematic represents the bracket which is used in aircraft, and you will find that it is the force is like 1500 Newton which is acting downward, and it is fixed for highlighted green surfaces in all degrees of freedom. So here while doing simulation, we need to refer below mentioned points and extract the results accordingly. So first point is like material is structural steel. Second, we need to find out the life, safety factor, sensitivity, bioaxial indication. And third, we need to find out the fatigue damage for 1.2e5 design life. So here you might not aware of what is fatigue life, safety factor, what is fatigue sensitivity, bioaxial indication. So what we can do now, we will go to our ANSYS, our blog, where we explain all these terminologies. We will go through that, and then later on we'll go to our actual simulation part, like how to perform fatigue simulation for this applied loading and boundary condition. We are inside our blog post, that is www.graphsengineering.com. So inside this blog post, you will find the various concepts explained which are related to finite element analysis as well as design. We also explain few quizzes like FEA quad quiz, as well as you will find few tips. And then we also started uploading the material details, and you can also find out the FEA CAD geometries for your practices from here. So let's move to our present topic, that is fatigue simulation. So here inside the fatigue FEA advance, you will find various blog posts. So now there are like present three blog posts which are related to fatigue analysis. So here I will suggest you to go through this first to explain what is fatigue analysis, to see what is exactly the fatigue analysis, what are the different stages of fatigue analysis, and also you can go through the fatigue design philosophies, what are the different philosophies. And at present video, we will discuss about the what are the concepts which are useful to perform the fatigue analysis. Okay, so if you click inside that, it will take you to this page. So this is what the page which explain the what are the different terms which are useful to perform you a fatigue simulations. Okay, so the term like as we know that what is endurance limit, fatigue limit, so all these things you will find here explain with the help of sketches or graphs. So what we can do now, we will just see which is useful for us. So now when we talk about fatigue, so what exactly fatigue means? So fatigue means like initiation, formation and propagation of crack in a material due to cyclic loading. All be aware of that when there is a cyclic load, it may leads to alternating stress, and that alternating stress may leads to the initiation, formation and propagation of a crack. And this graph is nothing but your endurance limit graph. So you can see like this is stress versus number of cycle. When it will go down after this, you will find there is no fatigue failure. So this point is nothing but your endurance limit. So when we talk about fatigue loading, it is very important term. Like when you have a fatigue loads. So you should be able to understand what kind of fatigue loads are there. So there are two major types of fatigue loading. First is your constant amplitude type, and the second one is your variable amplitude or non-constant loading. So when we talk about constant loading, it may varies further in three types. First is constant amplitude load, zero base. So basically, if you see this graph, you will find that it is basically varying from 0 to 1 like this. Okay. And when we talk about constant amplitude fully reverse, in that case, you will find that it is varying from positive 1 to minus 1. So like that, you will find the various peak and valley conditions. Okay. In the similar fashion, there is a third load case, which is like you can see like constant amplitude load ratio. So all these loads, what we can see from this graph, these are nothing but your constant loading. So which are either varying positive side or negative side. Okay. So when we talk about non-constant amplitude side, so you will find that variable or non-constant, as name suggests, you will find there is no constant loading, but it may vary drastically along this your vertical axis. So you can see like you have different values here, like from minus 400 to 832, and it is difficult to predict what is the exact value of this respective loading cycle. So when you have such a kind of loads, you need to refer non-constant variable amplitude loading. And in real life, most of the loads may comes under these categories. So while you will going to input this load, you need to select whether it is constant amplitude or variable amplitude load. So accordingly, software will calculate the fatigue life. Okay, there are further two more categories like proportional loading, non-proportional loading. So you can just go through that. So I will eliminate this for the present video. Neither it will take much more time. So let's talk about few important definitions. So I think you already aware what is mean stress. Mean stress is basically your maximum minus minimum, maximum plus minimum divided by 2. So basically it is nothing but the average of your max to minimum. When we talk about stress range, it is like max minus minimum. And when we talk about alternating stress, it is nothing but the average of your maximum minimum. Okay. So you can see like sigma max minus sigma minimum divided by 2. And similarly, there is one more terminology like stress ratio, which is your nothing but your maximum stress divided by minimum stress. Okay. There is one more important term, that is mean amplitude. So it is nothing but the ratio of your alternating stress to the mean stress. Okay. Now, when we do the simulation at that time, it will first ask for your load types. And next, it will ask for the respective strain which you need to refer to calculate the mean stresses. Okay, so I will suggest you just go through that. I will not explain right now. Mean stress theories, what are the mean stress theory? So basically, in short, the mean stress correction is not. If you see this graph, you will find that this is nothing but your constant loading, but it is offset. You can see like from zero mean it is offsetting. Okay. Now what the mean stress does, mean stress offset this curve to the equivalent cycle with no mean stress and same damage. You can see like, okay, it got shifted to the respective cycle, equivalent stress cycle. So here you can see the statement like mean stress correction is used to transfer a stress cycle to an equivalent stress cycle with zero mean stress, as shown figure below. So here you will find some mean stress value, but here it will get subtracted from max to minimum. So here basically you have a zero mean stress, but here you will have some offsets. So mean stress correction helps to transfer this respective cycle to the equivalent cycle. Okay. And there are four different mean stress corrections. So you just go through that. What are these? If we have time, we will discuss at the end of this video. So basically, the first is your Goodman method. The second one is your Soderberg method. And the third one is, you can see the Gerber. And the fourth one is ASME elliptical method. In short, the Goodman is nothing but when you connect your endurance stress value to the ultimate. And when we talk about Soderberg, instead of ultimate, you connect to the yield. And at the when we talk about Gerbil, you will find that this is nothing but the parabolic connections from between the ultimate and your endurance strength. And elliptical is as similar to your Söderberg. Only the difference is that when you connect ill to your respect to endurance strength, you will find this is nothing but the parabolic nature. You just have a look on this blog post, you will come to know what we have written and how this respective values, how this respective theories works. Okay, and these are the different formulas which are used for mean stress correction. This is the simplified form of your mean stress correction method. So if you see the difference between this graph and this graph here, this is the compression side is also given, and here it is the tensile side. So this graph belongs to the tensile side between the alternating stress and your mean stress curve. Okay, so you just have a look on this. Now let's talk about fatigue. Okay, this is fatigue life initiation. So I will suggest you just go through this as well as the what are the different fatigue life approaches. Okay, now when we talk about fatigue, there are two different methods to calculate the fatigue life. So the first one is like stress life approach and another is your strain life approach. Okay, so I think you will find that post related to here fatigue advances. So when you see what is fatigue and stages of analysis, fatigue analysis, you will find here the like three different stages like crack initiation, crack propagation and fracture. And then what are the different fatigue life estimation method, you will find the stress life and strain life. So I will suggest you to go through that. I will not explain right now. Okay, now let's move to our actual learning part. So there ANSYS learning part. So there we will discuss how to perform the ANSYS simulation. So now we are in our actual simulation part, that is ANSYS. So when we need to do the FAS simulation, so we just need to refer the analysis system. So at present we are doing the fatigue simulation, and before that we need to perform the static simulation. So you just need to drag and drop your static simulation in the schematic. So once your static structural analysis system is present, you just need to right click here and you just go inside the space claim or design modeler, or you can just import your respective geometry from your respective path. And once your geometry is imported, you just need to double click into the mechanical to load the geometry under the mechanical. So let's refer first the geometry inside the space claim. So you can see that this is the geometry which we need to refer inside the space claim. Okay, so right at present we will going to use the geometry as it is. We will not going to do any simplification. So let's move directly to the mechanical part. So you just need to double click over here. Once you will double click, your geometry will open under the mechanical. Okay, so now let's start with the simulation. The very first part is to assigning the material. So you can see like here there is a column called material. By default ANSYS will provide you a structural steel material. You will find that what are the different material details, as well as it will also give the your stress life SN curve. You can see like SN curve. So all the details for the respect to structural steel are present over here. If you want, you can right click and create material assigned, or you can create a new material also, or else you just go inside here, double click under the structural engineering data sources, and here you can refer a new material from engineering data source. Okay, so now if you see under the general materials, if you click on the general materials, there are various materials are available in the ANSYS library, so you can refer according to your product. Okay, now let's go, and in order to check the material whether it is assigned or not, you just need to click here, geometry, click here, and under the details you will find that which material is assigned. So here you can see the structural steel material is assigned. Now let's do the next part, that is mesh generation. So at present, we will not focus on the material, mesh generation part. So we will just directly use the global mesh sizing, which is present under the mesh. And here you can see like global mesh, how it is going to be done. Or in order to perform the local, right click insert, and you can define your sizing, select the part here, and here you can define your sizing, whatever the sizing you want. So let's make it 3 and generate the mesh. Okay, make sure that while doing fatigue simulation, your mesh should be much finer, okay, because it should report the peak stresses. So we will just go with this moderate mesh. When you will do simulation at your end, I will recommend you, or I will suggest you, to go with much finer mesh. Okay. Now let's apply your loading and boundary condition. The very first, we will apply our force, that is 1200 Newton. Insert force. Here you can see the force. Select the face. And here you can define the force in negative Y. So for that, refer component. Let's go here, minus 1200. Okay. Now you can see here we applied a force of 1200 Newton. Now the next case is to apply the boundary condition. So you just need to, as per the problem definition, let's select all the four faces, apply and lock all these degrees of freedom. So when you keep fixed support, it means that you are locking all degrees of freedom. So there is no translation and rotational movement. Okay. Now let's simulate this simulation. So right click and solve. It will take some time to perform the simulation. So once your simulation is done, then you can land up, or you can go with the fatigue simulation. So which is basically the analytical part. So we have time, so I will just take you through further our blog post. So okay. So while simulation is in progress, let's discuss few more terminologies, like what are the fatigue analysis outputs which we need to look while doing the fatigue simulations. Okay. So before that, let's discuss the reinforced cycle counting. So as we know that one of the best or most preferable cycle counting method is reinforced cycle counting. So if you see that there are different filtering methods. One of the method is like hysteresis filtering method. So in that method, what it does, just for example, refer this clock, you will find that this is what your complex cycle. And if you see here, what is your bottom point? This one. What is your maximum point? This one. And what is further your bottom point? This one. So if you see this last graph, you will find that it will connect the extreme points within the cycles, and it will eliminate the in-between points. So you can see that these two points are eliminated and your one curve is created. So likewise, it will does for all the remaining load cases. So what in simple method, it simplifies your loading cycle, okay, from complex to simple stress cycle. Now let's talk about the fatigue analysis output. So let's first check the simulation is done or not. Okay, so we will do later on. Now if you see our simulation is performed, let's check the deformation and stress cycles. So I'm just doing the simulation live in front of you, so don't think that it is though we are we did the recording, but the simulation is live. Now if you see that the deformation, let's check through the animation. Okay, so it should behave like that only because we are applying the downward load. So deformation is quite low, like 0.2 mm. Let's check the stress cycle stresses. So if you see here, the maximum stresses we observe at these points here as well as at this location. So these are the critical locations where you will find the alternating equivalent stresses. Okay, always remember where you will find the highest stresses in static simulation. At the same point, you will find the alternating equivalent stress in the fatigue simulations if you have a constant loading. Now let's do this our fatigue simulation, which was the area of interest of our present video. So in order to perform the fatigue simulation, you just need to right click insert, and here you can find that fatigue tool. So when we talk about fatigue analysis, you might confuse that we need to do a separate simulation. You can do the separate simulation. There are different softwares are available in the market, just as at present your ANSYS. Even there is one more software called ENCODE, which is widely used to perform the fatigue simulation for a complex loading. There are few other simulations like Abacus, SolidWork, but there also is simplified fatigue simulation, NASTANPAD. So these other softwares are there where you will find the fatigue simulation. Even there are few tools where you can, which are actually formed just to perform the fatigue simulation, just like ENCODE. Present simulation is basically based on your this static analysis result. So the fatigue simulation is nothing but your post-processing part. So based on your SN curve for the respective material and based on your loading outputs like peak and valley condition, it generates the life cycle and other fatigue analysis output. Okay, there is no separate simulation we are just doing. We are just referring the static analysis result, and based on your material inputs and loads inputs, we are just calculating the fatigue analysis output. So when you import the fatigue, you will find that, as we discussed at the beginning of video, there are different load types. So when we talk about zero base, so you can see it is varying from 0 to 1 like that. When we talk about fully reverse, so minus 1 to plus 1. And when we talk about the ratio, you can see, right? And you can see the history data. So it is basically for when you have a variable amplitude, you just define the path and you can read that file. Okay. At present, let's consider the fully reverse cycle. Okay. So what we are doing, we are assuming that this respective load is varying from positive to negative in a, you can see like this. And now let's check the analysis type. So as I discussed earlier, there are main two approaches like stress life and strain life. So let's simulate the simulation with strain life. And as we discussed earlier, there are different theories of mean stress corrections. So let's consider the Goodman stress theory, and let's consider the equivalent stress to calculate the fatigue life. Okay, and here the results, what results you want, either a strain or stress. So let's check these stresses. Okay, and inside that, once you define your loading condition for a fatigue, right click insert, and you will find there are different fatigue outputs, just like your life, just like your safety factor, just like your biaxial indication. And let's talk about the fatigue sensitivity. Okay, so before discussing all this parameter, let's evaluate this result. What we will do, we will go to our blog post, and there I will just explain you what are these different terms are there. So now let's discuss about the fatigue analysis output. The very first outputs we are interested for a fatigue simulation is fatigue life. So when we talk about fatigue life, it is nothing but the available life for a given fatigue cycle. So if you see this respective counter plot, you will find that the maximum numbers belongs to the cycle. You can see here, like in this figure 11 shows that the fatigue life of bracket, the maximum life 1 is to 6 is corresponding to the maximum cycle to failure in a SN curve. So when you refer any SN curve, you will find that the different life cycles, the maximum cycle to failure is nothing but your this maximum cycle, okay? And this minimum cycle corresponds to the minimum life cycle of this respective component. When you refer the color, this respective legend through the color code, you can easily identify. If you probe your cursor here at this respective, you will find this life cycle is in between the 1:5 to 7.27:4. Okay, so minimum life cycle this respective component will withstand is 7.27:8:4. Now the next important factor of output of fatigue simulation is fatigue damage. So when we talk about fatigue damage, it is also as same as it will also display in the similar fashion, but here the fatigue damage is nothing but the ratio of design life to the available life. Okay, so basically whatever the when you refer any product, you should have some design life. Okay, like this respective component should withstand 1:5 cycles. That is your design life. But when you do the simulation after applying load cases, you will get some life that is called your available life. So the ratio of this design life to available life is nothing but your fatigue damage. So for fatigue damage, values greater than 1 indicates the failure. So always remember, fatigue damage should be below 1. Okay, when we say that your fatigue damage is below 1, it means that your component is safe. When we say that our fatigue damage is greater than 1, it means that whatever the life which you got is not exceeding the design life. Okay, in simple. So always choose the respective probe values. Here you can easily probe the values. Like if you want to see here, your fatigue damage is 0.23. If you probe here, your fatigue damage is 0.1. Okay. Now let's the important terminology is safety factor. This damage accumulation is nothing but it is just the sum of your fatigue damage for the respective number of cycles. When you have different number of cycles, you can easily simulate that. And cumulative thing is nothing but your cumulative fatigue damage. Now let's discuss one more important parameter, that is safety factor. So the fatigue safety factor is a counter plot of factor of safety with respect to the fatigue failure at a given design life. So basically it is nothing but the factor of safety with respect to your fatigue failure for a given design life. Okay. Now when we talk about the value less than 1, it indicates the failure before the design life is reached. And the maximum factor safety displayed is 15. So if you see this legend, you will find that the maximum value which is displayed is 15 and the minimum is varying from 0 to 1. So it says that when the values indicates less than 1, in that case, we can say that it will going to fail before it will reach its design life. Okay, so for that indication, it is useful to see the safety factor. So if you see here, this color code region which represent 0.859, it is nothing but the critical region, or you can say that the failure will going to happen at this respective location when you apply the further fatigue load before reaching its design life. Now let's talk about one more important parameter, that is biaxiality indications. So when we talk about biaxial indication, it gives the user some idea of a state over the model. Okay, so basically it shows the state of the stress. So when we say that, if you see, refer this respect to legend, when we say that the biaxiality is 0, it corresponds, 0 means somewhere here, it corresponds to the uniaxial stress value. Okay, so if you see here, this color code here, you will have the uniaxial stresses. When you will say that your biaxial indication is 1, it corresponds to the pure shear condition. So minus 1 somewhere here, you can see it states the pure shear state. Now when we say the positive 1 value, it is nothing but the pure biaxial state. So positive 1 means the maximum values, I think the somewhere here you can see inside this location. So this is nothing but your pure biaxial stress. Okay, so it might be confuse you while referring this, but when you do the number of simulation, then you will come to know that how to interpret this respect to output. So it is nothing but the biaxial indication is the ratio of, you can say, like maximum principal stress to the larger principal stress. Okay, now the next important parameter is like fatigue sensitivity. So let's, what does it shows that? Let's take an example of like you are applying a force of 1200 Newton. Now, if you want to see the results for like 200% load factor, like instead of 1200, you want to see the result for 2400. So whether you need to do the simulation. Similarly, if you want to apply a 50% load, like instead of 1200 Newton, if you want to apply a 1600 Newton, whether you want to do a further simulation, in that case, you can say no, if you referring to this respect to fatigue sensitivity chart. Okay, so what it does, it basically varies your load value from minus 15% to the 150%. So you can even put that value like 10%, 2%. So based on that respect to load minimum to maximum, you can easily interpret the design life. Okay, that is what this fatigue sensitivity shows. What we can do now, we can go to our ANSYS and there we can see how to see this result. Now if you see that we had received our outputs, the first one is like fatigue life. So let's see what is the fatigue life. Now you can see like here, these are the critical parts. You can probes, right? Even you can probe over here. You can probe this respect to region. This might go when you do the further fine mesh show. That's why mesh is very important in this case. So you can see here the minimum life is 2.9 e raised to 5. Okay. The another parameter is like safety factor. So as we discuss safety factor, you just need to check whether it is. So this one, this is what the critical reason which below one. So we can say that it's failing. Okay. Now we can see. Right. Now let's check the another indication, that is biaxial indication. So it's varying like minus 0.99 to the 0.96. So when we say this value somewhere here, it's state your pure biaxial state minus one is here, your shear, and when we say one or here somewhere middle, it is your uniaxial state. Now let's check the another important parameter, that is fatigue sensitivity. So as we applied here like 50% to 150%, you can even vary that also. Let's make it 200% and evaluate the results. So when we say the, now let's talk about our force value, that is 1200 Newton. And for that we receive the design life is like here 2.9. So let's check here, right? So this is what our one load, the maximum load, and for that respect to 2.9 we saw e raised to 5. Now suppose if you increase the load further, like if you goes on increasing load like two times, your fatigue life will drastically reduce to 20,000. Suppose if you increase by 1.5 times, then your fatigue life will be in between like here 40 to 30,000. Now suppose if you further reduce your load from 1 to instead of 0.75, so let's go up 0.75 means here, so your fatigue life will increase to 1.10 raised to 6. Okay, that is what the advantage of fatigue sensitivity. So you can easily vary these values and you can check the respective graph instead of performing the simulation. So if you check here for 1.5, it is 57,000. Okay. Now let's check. I think we forgot one thing. Let is checking the damage. Okay, now here, if you remember, our damage is 1.25, for which we need to find out the damage. So let's evaluate first. Now if you see that here we are getting a very much like 1000 10000, because here design life is 1:9, but our design life is 1.25:6. Now let's check here whether it is below 1 or not. So you can see like it is 1.2524. So accordingly, if you want to vary your design life damage, your fatigue damage is value. So basically your fatigue damage is nothing but the ratio of your design life to your permissible life. So what I can do, let's put 2.1:6, evaluate the result. Okay, let's check what is 2.9:5. Now further check our damage and put here values 2.1:5. I'm just reducing the values below that. So if you see here, our design life we reduce compared to this 2.9. okay, you should have this highest value always. Now if you remove 2.9, then you can find that your factor of safety is which below the 1. So accordingly you can play with this the different outputs of fatigue analysis. Okay, so that's it guys. At present our purpose is just to start the fatigue analysis simulation with this simplified problem. So at present we just applied a simple problem and we just followed the fully reverse cycle stress life approach and Goodman mean stress theory. So we will do further simulations. You just put a comment whatever the simulation you want to look, you are looking for, like either zero base fully reverse ratio, or if you are looking for non constant amplitude or variable amplitude, even with different stress life and different strain life, or different mean stress correction theories approaches, we can do that. Okay, in the once I will review your feedback on this video, I will do the next simulation according to that. Okay, so that's you guys. Thank you. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.